Nobody plays guitar like this guy.
Hey, are you ready to learn how to put wow factor into Wagon Wheel by Old Crow Medicine Show? Or Darius Rucker did a cover on this one also. Hey, this is a great song for beginners. If you're ready to learn how to put wow factor into that strumming, to learn how to play it right, step into the studio. It's only got four chords. You're going to love it. Come on in. Hey, this is a great song by the Old Crow Medicine Show called Wagon Wheel. Darius Rucker did this too, and his version is just as cool, and we might even throw some licks in that he's got in there. This is a great song for beginners. There's only four chords to this song, but I'm going to show you how to strum it the right way, the way they're playing it on there, so we can get that wow factor into the strumming. There's not a whole lot of licks in there, just maybe some of the fills that we'll do on the chords for the... like that. But there's only four chords of this song. Even if you're a very beginner player and you can just got your basic chords down, you'll be able to do this one. And it'll be a great song for you as a beginner to learn how to start putting wow factor into your strumming. I don't know why I keep going on like this. Let's get into this song. Let's start learning Wagon Wheel by, what are we going to call it? Old Crow Medicine Show or Darius Rucker, whoever you like best, I guess. We can do it that way. Hey, let's get in the studio. Come on, let's learn these chords. Okay, let me show you the chords that we're using. They're four simple chords. You have your G chord, a D chord, E minor, and C. What really makes this song is the strumming. I've seen a lot of people do this song and they play the same strumming throughout, and that's not the way to really get that wow factor. There's two different strumming patterns here. You've got a strumming pattern on the G and the D, and a separate strumming pattern on the E minor and the C. Okay? Now let me show you what the chords for the verses go like this. You've got a G, a D, E minor, C. Now, I'm not doing the strumming pattern that I'm going to play. I'm just showing you the chords now. Then he goes back to a G, D, and a C. So the chords are G, D, E minor, C. Second line is G, D, C. And you play that C on for two counts there. Now, here's where your strumming comes in. The strumming pattern for the first strumming pattern is on your G and your D, and it's like this. Now, I don't go up, down, up, down, up, down, okay? It's hard for me to do it like that. I just want you to listen to it. Feel this song with your heart. When you're playing guitar, you want to feel it with your heart. Don't worry about the notes on that page. Those notes are going to help you tell you where to play it, but you have to feel that song to really put that wow factor into it. So on this one, here's what the strumming pattern is like this. Now, you want to try and hit that bass note on the G chord. You want to use your ring finger to hit that bass note on the third fret of the sixth string. Hit that one time, and then play your chord. So it's a bass note. And all that's really just up and down. I'm just a smooth strum. But you got to hear how that's played. Then you go to your D. So you're going to play your bass note there is going to be the fourth string. Open four, right? Same pattern. G, now when you go to your E minor, it's real simple. You hit that open six and just one downstroke on the chord, but you do it twice. Like that. Same thing with your C chord. Now there you're hitting that third fret of the fifth string. Okay? So all the way through, two strumming patterns. Strum pattern one, strum pattern two. C. Now, here's what's cool. On that second line of that first verse, right, where you go G, D, C, that C has four counts. The first two counts, you play strum pattern two for it, right? The second pattern. And then you do that strum pattern one. So here's what I'm talking about. That kind of sounds confusing. It's not. It goes like this. Here we go. Next pattern. See what I'm saying? You would normally think you're just going to keep hitting that like that, but you don't. Hit that twice. Now play it with me one time through. Ah, did you get that one on that second C? Yeah. Start over there. Get that intro, you want to put some wow factor into that intro, you want to get the intent of the song where he's playing that fiddle. And it's just like you're playing those chords. And to get those sounds, all I'm doing is you're playing that, you've got your C chord formed, you're going to take your middle finger off. And you're going to hammer on that third string, open to, and then to the second fret. Hammer on that second fret. Da 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 da, da 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 da. Right? So it's like this. Okay. And you go right to that G chord. All you're doing there is I've got my G chord. Boom, ba-da-da-da-da. You're just getting that sound in there, and I'm going on the first and on the second and third string, first fret on the second, second fret on the third. Boom, ba-da-da-da-da. Then I go to that D, and right there I'm taking my pinky and I'm putting it on the fourth fret of that third string to get that sound. And when I do that E, I'm just strumming it through, just like a regular pattern. And on that, then I get to that C, and I'm just kind of maybe, you can do some different fillings here. I'm just kind of lifting up my middle finger on that fourth string. And you can, when you're playing that E, you can take that ring finger up off of that fourth string and just kind of give it a little bit of a flavor there, maybe a little bit of a hammer on, okay? And same thing on that C. And all I'm doing there is lifting that middle finger up on that fourth string, a little hammer onto that second fret of the fourth string. Okay, play along with me now. Let's just go ahead and go through this. We'll play the intro and then we'll do a verse or two, right? But same chord pattern, so this should be pretty easy for you. So let's try that. Okay, here we go. One, two, and we're going to start with the intro. One, two, three, four. that's it for the whole song, and you just keep playing that over and over and over again. I just love this song. It's so simple to play, but it's a lot of fun. I hope you enjoyed this one. Let me share a little message with you real quick. Okay, now this message that I have for you today, I just want to tell you a real short message about Jesus. This, I'm speaking really to believers here, people that have accepted Jesus as their Savior. Now, if you don't know Jesus, oh my gosh, I want to talk to you as well, and I'll share with you how that you can know Him as your Savior and have eternal life. But right now, I want to share this little quick message with believers, and I want you to understand that how important it is that we do what the Lord tells us to do. This message that I want to share with you comes out of John, the second chapter of John, and I'm only going to read a couple of verses, but listen to this. This was actually the first miracle that Jesus actually performed, where He turned water into wine at the wedding of Cana. And here's what it says. This is chapter 2 in the Gospel of John. It says this: On the third day there was a wedding in Cana of Galilee, and the mother of Jesus was there. And the mother of Jesus was there. Now both Jesus and His disciples were invited to the wedding. And when they ran out of wine, the mother of Jesus said to Him, "They have no wine, Jesus." And Jesus said to her, "Woman, what does your concern have to do with Me? My hour has not yet come." Now, let me share this with you. I know that sounds harsh, but if we had more time, I'd go into that study. That was just a term of endearment, really. He was not talking down to His mother like that. Don't have time to get into all that now, but He was not being ridiculing her at all. And then His mother said to the servants, and this is the key phrase right here, the key verse that I want you to hear. And His mother said to the servants, "Whatever He says to you to do, do it." In other words, whatever Jesus says to do, do it. I have a note in my Bible there that says some of the best advice ever given. Whatever He says to do, do it. I don't know how close you are to Jesus right now, if you're a Christian, how your walk is going, but I know that to continue walking stronger and closer to Jesus, it's a matter of our hearts and our minds thinking of Him constantly and listening to Him what it tells us what to do. And He's there sharing with us every single moment of the day. Jesus never leaves us. In fact, the Bible says that He thinks about us more times a day then there are grains of sand on the beach. That's how much He loves us. You know that if Jesus had a wallet, your photographs would be in it. If He had a refrigerator, the pictures that you draw would be on it. And if Jesus had a tree, He'd carve a heart and put your initials in it. That's how much He loves you. So that last verse that I just shared with you, great advice for you and I that are Christians, believers. Great advice to go with, right? Whatever He tells you to do, do it. Hey, you know what? I don't know how much of Jesus you have in your heart, but I know this. You got all you want. See you soon.